pawn shop owners, what was the best reaction you have seen out of someone that tried to sell you something that was completely worthless? Having worked at a pawn shop before, I can say there are plenty of amazing stories of customers and their antics. Usually the best stories revolve around jewelry. This one woman came in with a big gold colored ring and wanted to get a few $100s for it. Picking it up and looking at it, I could tell it was super fake, and I tried to explain that to her. She wouldn't buy it because the street vendor told me it was solid 14 kilotons. I went and picked up our huge earth magnet and put it near the ring, and it shot right to it. I explained that solid gold is not magnetic. She was stunned and couldn't believe that she had spent like $200 for it. The best one I had was a lady trying to pawn her grandma's antique DVD player. She said it was like 50 years old and wanted $100. I showed her the stamp on the back that said it was made in 2009, and she said, "Oh, I grabbed the wrong one." A 50-year-old DVD player would be pretty valuable since it was only invented about 20 years ago. I own a similar store. People still think their Beanie Babies have value. People also tend to think what items sell for online are what they will sell for at the same price and speed locally. I don't own one, but I did work for a couple of years. The most memorable one was only about 30 seconds. Large sweaty man walks in with a belt sander, set it down on the counter in front of me and plugged right in. Made direct eye contact and switched it on. The sander immediately made a loud popping sound and smoke begin to rise. Unplugged it, turned around and walked out without a single word between us. I used to work at a surf shop. We used to throw the crappy boards, ones we couldn't sell, were broken or were projects for later in the backyard of the shop. One night someone stole some of the boards unbeknownst to us, and then he came round and tried to sell them to us. Yes, he tried to sell us the boards he stolen from us. My boss just laughed and said, "These are so terrible, we will just throw them in the backyard." So now he had stolen boards that no one wanted and had to dispose of. I used to have to go to the pawnbrokers quite frequently when I was younger and got to know some of the dealers. They often showed me some of the stuff people brought in, a large collection of P-tapes, adult toys and an incubator that had been loaned out by a hospital. No idea why the dealers accepted that one. Hey, I was the dummy on this one. I looked into a pawn shop store and there was a sign saying, "Why are 1968 pennies worth almost $20? I looked through my penny collection and found a 1968 penny. I walked into the shop and showed him my penny. Then he began smiling and snickering and giggling. And, all of a sudden, I realized I did not have 1968 pennies. I had one penny. That guy was a real smartass. I do not frequent pawn shops anymore. Dang dude, that's just plain old annoying. Good way to get some foot traffic in there, but everyone who went in for the same reason as you had the propensity to get really annoyed. Not the owner, but I worked in a small pawn shop for about 3 years, and my personal favorite was a greasy guy came in and dumped out a garbage bag of broken computer fans and a few assorted computer parts. We laughed for a few minutes and realized this guy was serious. My boss asked him how much he wanted for it all, and the guy said he didn't know how much it would be worth, but he heard there was gold in computer parts. We had to break it to this guy that the plastic computer fans had no gold in them and we can check out the other parts. My boss gave him $5 for his trouble. My dad runs one. One guy brought in a huge bag of wheat pennies expecting to walk out with a big payday, but really they aren't worth all that much. I think he offered the guy like $20 and he stormed off mad. 20 plus years owning one, and I can spot fake gold without touching it. People never believe the chain they bought from the guy at the gas station for $50 isn't real. Never. Seeing people's reactions to this varies from "they knew it" to "I'm going to kill him." Not an owner, but I'm a frequent shopper. Saw the Me Head couple try and sell their off-brand, wires-cut, 20-inch car stereo speakers for $200. When the guy wouldn't bite, they flipped out yelling, "You legally have to buy anything." They threw such a tantrum he called the cops. They were arrested, car searched, and wouldn't you know, drugs all up in it. Afterward I got a good deal on some cordless power tools. I worked in one for a few years. Not really a best reaction, but a girl came in already in tears holding an engagement ring. Everyone at a pawn shop feels obliged to tell you why they are selling pawning, and she told me she had recently moved across the country and had just found out that her fiancé had married her friend back home. The big problem was that I could tell it was a fake as she was walking in the door. All I could tell her was, if you thought he was in butthole before you came in here, you're not going to like what I'm about to tell you. Ended up giving her $5 for a worthless ring just to give her something, and she ended up a bit happier cause she now had something new to hate him for and couldn't wait to tell him. Oh man. My great uncle owns a pawn shop, and some of the crap there is hilarious or heartbreaking. People trying to sell free old TVs they got on Craigslist for hundreds of dollars because now they are vintage. Obviously rented instruments for their kids' band class that have tags on them from the rental place. And oh geez. Do people get peed about engagement rings? He literally has a bag of engagement rings. They're so easy to come by. Women tend to be sad when they find out they get almost nothing or are fake. Men tend to get aggressive. Enough that he has my cousin up front watch out extra careful when he tells a dude he can't pay really much of anything for what the dude thought was an investment ring. The excuses people make when obviously stolen stuff are just horrible, especially if he asks them if they can prove they are the owner of the item. On the other hand, if someone is in trying to sell their wedding ring, especially if it's a lady with kids, he is being known to just give them $50 and send them on their way. My cousin who works with him has a stack of brochures for drug and alcohol treatment resources and stuff like that that she regularly gives out. I would like to share the opposite. Girls thought they had worthless cards ended up being very worthwhile. I worked in a comic book shop that also sold trading cards. In this case, Magic: The Gathering. Two young girls came in, maybe 14/15 years old, with a small box of cards. They said they found it on their uncle's closet that passed away, figured it was worthless, and just wanted to see the worth. I thought the same, and opened up the box of cards to take a quick glance and was a little alarmed at what I saw. Alpha and Beta cards, a couple of Power 9 cards, and this was just the first 10 cards in. I stopped, said, "I'm really sorry, I'm not familiar with these older cards." I lied, "I just wasn't authorized to try to buy something of this magnitude. I'll need to call the store owner." I called him, and at first he was annoyed because the other store he was visiting had a Ford Plow through the front window. He just said to not bother with a trade-in until I causally mentioned some of the cards there in the stack. He said, "Don't let those cards leave the building. I'm on my way," and hung up. The girls couldn't wait, and I asked if they wouldn't mind leaving the cards with me, along with their names and phone numbers, and we could get back to them. When the owner came in, he went to the back, got some gloves, and went through all the cards. I stayed after my shift because I just wanted to see it unfold. The owner gained like 10,000 respect points from me when the girls and an older woman, presumably somebody's mother, came back in, as he was straight with them. He said, "What you have here is all very worthwhile. There isn't a card in this box that would sell for less than about $5. But these cards here," he found out some cards that I couldn't see, "are the most valuable in the box. And this one," he pulled a card away, "would sell for the price of these, and the entire box, at least twice as much. I do not have enough money available to make you a fair offer. What you have here is easily worth about $20,000 to a collector." The girls' mouths dropped open. The owner offered them everything he had available in the shop, about $6,000. They accepted. Also work in a shop, and sometimes it feels nice to tell people they do have a gold mine instead of the same worthless polybag death of Superman no one gives a frick about. Not a pawn shop, but I used to work at a mobile electronics store. Alarms, cruise controls, stereos, etc. Had a guy come in with a box full of outdated high-end stereo equipment, head unit, EQ, preamp, 3 amplifiers, and some nice crossovers. I told him that most of it was worthless to me, but offered him $40 cash or $65 store credit. He flipped out and began a rant about how all this stuff cost over $2,000 when he bought it, yeah, 16 years ago. I calmly explained that he may be able to get more for it on eBay or something, but I have to make a profit so I cannot offer much. I also explained I wouldn't have offered anything if I wasn't personally interested in the crossovers. He slammed everything back into the box and stomped out while calling us every name in the book. As he was walking out the door, he looked back over his shoulder, yelled something and flipped us off. This is where he messed up, since he wasn't looking where he was stepping. He tripped over the curb and spilled the entire box of gear into a huge puddle, a very deep pothole full of rain. It was hard not to stick my head out the door and bellow out a loud "Ha!" Heard this one. A guy tried to sell a vintage $5 bill, thinking it was worth over $4,000. The bill was made in 2016. I was a pawnbroker for a while. So many junkies trying to sell fake jewelry, but this one lady really stood out. She came in with a chain and pendant in a cute little box. First thing we do is look for marking. While I was doing that, she started getting feisty, yelling at me saying, "Why are you doing that? Don't you see it says made in Italy? Hey, stop, are you blind?" At this point I'm like, "Okay lady, we can't take this. It's not real gold." And she just flips out saying, "It doesn't matter, it's from Italy," and this and that. Called me stupid and flipped the finger at all the staff. All we did is laugh, but as she revved off she hit a BMW and the owner saw her. We turned over the security taping to the cops. Frick that lady, lol. I worked in a buy sell trade video game store. Day after day, people would come in with common Atari stuff, PS2 Rock Band guitars and drum sets, throwaway original Xbox or PlayStation 1 games, Superman 64, yada yada yada. They would be so happy and excited, and I had to be the one to break it to them that they weren't going to get hundreds of dollars for their crap, but I spent $60 on it when it was new. We have taken really good care of it. We have never even used it. It's for the N64. Isn't it vintage? What do you mean a third-party Xbox controller isn't worth the trade-in price for a Microsoft brand one? They're the same thing. Day in, day out, I had a woman who threw a complete fit that we wouldn't take her Wii Rock Band drum set or two guitars. She also had 25 DVDs, an original Xbox and a Wii, neither of which could read discs, and about 30 bottom shelf games. All of the discs were scratched to oblivion, and everything reeked of cigarette smoke and was yellow. When I told her that the only things we could take were the two controllers that came with the Xbox, she yelled, threw the box of DVDs on the floor and proceeded to rearrange games on our shelves as she stormed out. The man she was with just picked everything up and they left. They tried going to our second location, but we called them and let them know what had happened. They got the same deal there, and she threw the same fit. That's the problem with running a local video game store. Most people think they have a secret gold mine when they just have run-of-the-mill crap. I buy and repair typewriters. It's an odd niche hobby of mine more than anything. Typewriters can go for a lot of money, but most aren't honestly worth what people want. 85% of typewriters are worth no more than $125 in pristine condition. Many times people will try to sell their inherited typewriters for $50 to $1,000 more in some cases than they're worth. I've seen one person try to sell a typewriter to me for $650 because he saw one online for $700 in a different color. I had bought the exact same typewriter 3 days before for $63. One typewriter. Several people were trying to all sell them for $150, $250. I bought one, in amazing condition, better than the higher priced ones for $70. Just because someone labels something a price and or because it's old doesn't mean it's worth that price or valuable. That's not how it works. I think people just see an eBay selling price and assume that someone will automatically buy it from them for that price. It's frustrating. I once had this old fellow try to sell me a tribal wooden African figure in a grass skirt. You know the type. When I told him it was worthless, he tried to convince me that the skirt was made out of real lion's mane. When I inevitably shot him down and called his bluff, he pulled a big lighter out of his pocket. "Do you wanna buy this instead then?" I worked at a pawn shop. One time, a guy came in with a DVD VCR combo, brand new in the box. We, the pawn shop employees, would always engage the customer in conversation while looking at the item, partly to feel out the customer and see if they had inconsistencies in their story that may indicate stolen goods. So I started the conversation. "Ro, this is a nice unit. Where do you get this?" "Best Buy. Just bought it a couple days ago." "Oh, nice. But you want to sell it to us? Why not just return it to Best Buy?" "Oh yeah, I can't find the receipt. But I bought it right down the street at the Best Buy like 2 blocks from here." While we talk, I'm pulling the unit out of the box and checking the cables and remote, looking on the bottom for a serial number. As I flip the bottom of the unit toward me, I see that it has a giant sticker on it that says "Property of Rent-A-Center." Do not buy or sell. I didn't say a word to him. My boss was watching over my shoulder. As soon as the boss saw the sticker, he pulled out a Polaroid camera, snapped the guy's picture, cussed him out, and practically threw the DVD VCR at the guy. I sent a fax to the other pawn shops in town to give them a heads up. Hardcore Porn, a reality show based out of a pawn shop in Detroit, Michigan, had just aired an episode where a woman had a Burmese ruby in her jewelry and she got $10,000 for it. For the following month, anyone who had a red colored stone came strolling into my store thinking they had the same thing. Spoiler alert, nobody did. If you really want to see worthless things with high price tags, go into New Orleans Craigslist org and look for RVs and boats. I went to look at an RV here and the guy wanted $4,000 for it, and it basically had rotted out from termites and lots of water damage. After I showed him just how badly it was damaged, he then said he really needed to get rid of it to just make an offer. I had to inform him that it was beyond repair and I couldn't take it even if he gave it to me. He might be able to get some cash out of it by selling it in parts or for parts. I see listings like this all the time. A 15-20 year old RV that is now junk because no one repaired the roof leak. And the owner is like, but it was 45k when it was new. Same with boats down here. No lowball offers. I know what I have. My other favorite is firearms. People want to sell a handgun for like $50 less than MSRP for a gun that's been shot 500 times and has been custom amateur gunsmithed by Uncle Bubba. Currently work at a pawn shop. People think silver is worth a lot more than it is. I get people thinking they'll get $400 for a chain that's worth maybe $30. Other than that, collectibles memorabilia disappoints most people. Not much in that category. While working for my grandpa, someone tried to sell us a gold ring that wasn't marked. It was probably just plated, so my grandpa offers based on what he could get from it, and the seller tried to complain saying someone else would give them more. We offer another dollar and they still complained, so my grandpa told them if they get more somewhere else, why'd they stop here in the first place? I worked at Sam Ash for a long while. You can sell instruments there. Not exactly a pawn shop, but the same concept. Guy walks in with two very nice, obviously handmade boutique basses. One is left-handed, one is right-handed. Obviously a red flag that a novice wouldn't even think about. Hey, I want to sell my basses. Okay. Any particular reason? I don't play them anymore. I see. Just couldn't decide if you were left or right-handed. He wants $700 for both. Looking at them, I figured they were $3-4k each. Problem was they didn't have a name, just a logo. Lots of googling later and we have a brand. Call the builder up and his warehouse was robbed weeks before. Police are called, guy arrested, and as fast as I know, builder gets his basses back. I got a "I'd like to come down sometime and buy you lunch as a thank you for your work" from the builder. Still waiting on that lunch. You have been visited by the science doggo. Upvote now and you will get high grades and good results within the next week. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.